Now, in the last one, we need to find the mistake the student made. And this is how I suggest you do that. Okay. So it says David was working on his homework over a Zoom call with his friend Matthew. Matthew said his answer was wrong. Describe where David made his mistake and give the correct answer. So here's the work. Something in here is wrong. This is how I suggest you find that. I suggest you solve this problem and then see how it's different than what they're doing. Okay, so if I wanted to solve that problem, or if I wanted to solve for x, I would do this. Here's the angle we're using, angle A. This side is the hypotenuse. This side is adjacent to angle A. If I look at the ratios, the ratio cosine uses adjacent and hypotenuse. Adjacent and hypotenuse. So I know we need to use the cosine ratio. So it would look like this. Cosine of 33.7 is equal to the length of the adjacent leg divided by the hypotenuse. And right away you see what they did wrong, what David did wrong. David grabbed the wrong trig function, or the trig ratio. He used sine when he should have used cosine. Okay, so in the answer I would say something like this. David used sine when he should have used cosine, or something like that. Should have used cosine. Okay. It's not just enough to say he used the wrong. Oh, you guys can't see that. It's not just enough to say he used the wrong trig ratio. You have to say he used the wrong one, and which one should he have used. And then we could solve this. Cross multiply, divide. So what was that? Cosine of 33.7 degrees times 12. 10. That rounds to 10. Okay. And see, there you go. You can see that a little bit better. 9.98. That rounds to 10. So I know x should be 10. So all of this should be your answer. Now be careful though, because it's not just that easy. There may be other mistakes in here. Like let's say David did use cosine. Here's another mistake David could have made. Instead of writing it as x over 12, maybe David would have wrote 12 over x, because this would also give you the wrong answer. Okay. So just solve it and then compare what you have with what they have. And then even though ours does look a little bit different, they do the same thing here. 12 times the function. So that's what we do. 12 times the function. We just don't write it out the way they did. So then also make sure they cross multiply correctly, right? Because technically they do this. They cross multiply this way. 12 times sine of 33.7. Which they cross multiply correct, but they started with the wrong trig ratio. So just look for the different things, make sure you have the correct answer, and you say what was wrong with their answer.